Dwayne, getting back, expectations at Lutcher are so high, you know that more than anybody, and to finally get back, kind of take the onus off your back a little bit?
Yeah, you would think in most places a six-year gap wouldn't be that big, but it feels like an eternity. And for me personally, it feels like an eternity when you think I've been coaching since 2002, six trips. That's only 21 seasons, so to go 6 years in between trips, it feels pretty long, but I guess we did that from 2008 into 2015 was an extra year there, but we're excited. Obviously, our kids understand what our history is. They hear it from me. I mean, I heard it as a player from Coach Dettillier, so they know what the history is. They know what the expectations are. They know what people think of them, and we've talked about it. Our kids know that we're looking for number nine. We talk about hanging banner number nine in our locker room, but that comes from, if you ever walked into our basketball gym, we're different from most schools. Most schools will have playoff appearances, a quarterfinal appearances, a semifinal appearances, a state runner-ups. When there's 51 banners hanging on the wall, there's no room for any of those other things. So in Lutcher, if you want to be remembered or you want to be a great team, there's only one way to do it, and that's to win in a season Superdome.
I'd be remiss not to ask, but the new format, you're getting to the championship game, so obviously it's worked pretty well for you. How do you like it?
Well, I think for us, we thought this year could be a good year. We didn't know if we had the talent that it takes overall, top to bottom on our roster. We knew we'd be a good football team. For me, the format, and I've been fortunate to sit on that executive committee, and I told guys, let's not look at numbers, let's not look at school names, let's look at what's best for football in Louisiana. And getting everybody back into the Superdome is what's best for football in Louisiana. Getting teams, whether you agree with how they divide it or not, it's fair. It's divided on a fair basis where it's enrollment based. Just like you do classifications, throw the classifications paper, ball it up, put it in the trash can. This is the definition of select. These are your 160 schools in select. Divide them up into quarters. Here's your 200 schools in non-select. Divide them up into four quarters and let's see where they land. For us, it took us from being one of the 10 or 12 smaller schools in 4A and put us probably right dead smack in the middle of this new Division II. We're probably significantly smaller than the team that we're playing enrollment-wise Friday, but it is what it is. You go out there and play the game.
You know, just to talk about DeJuan, yeah, but first off, the 17 straight carries last week, you call those plays. You weren't going to do anything else, were you?
There wasn't. We've gotten a lot of notoriety over the end of that game from Friday night, and one of the things that we talked about with our kids all week long was just about being a physically dominant football team. And that probably goes against what people have seen from me in the past, having the quarterbacks that we've had that's been able to air it out and throw it all over the place. The receivers, the Jarvis Landrys, the Eldontre Davises, those guys who played for us, the Gerard Landrys. We talked about being physically dominant. And that game was on the line. We were up by one score. We knew we needed to run clock. We knew we needed another touchdown. And we just challenged our guys, and nobody else was getting to carry that football. He wasn't going to let anybody else carry that football, so we made the personnel switch. We went with 22 personnel. We brought in two tight ends. We brought in a linebacker. We brought in a strong safety, lined them up in the backfield, and ran quarterback power, 17 straight plays. Ran off almost 8 minutes of clock, scored the touchdown to make it a two-score game, and then got the ball back again, picked up one first down, and was able to run out the clock.
And how good is he, Coach, for the sake of those that haven't seen him yet?
I haven't shied away from saying this. I know we've got guys who've got five stars up and down the state of Louisiana. There's a lot of guys that are rated higher for recruiting services. He's the best player in the state of Louisiana. He is on a team that doesn't have any other superstars on it. He's on a team that doesn't have the supporting cast that many others have. I think he's the best player in the state. And when you do what he does on a weekly basis, I think nine times this year he scored five or more touchdowns in a game. He's closing in on, I don't know, almost 5,000 yards of total offense, getting close to 70 touchdowns. I think it's hard to argue.
Your opponent, multiple state championship coach, and obviously a good team as well. Talk about that.
Yeah, North DeSoto's had a dominant football season. I think they're a program that's on the rise. I think you'll be seeing a lot more from the North DeSoto Griffins under Coach Dennis Dunn, who's obviously built another dynasty in the 90s, in the early 2000s at Evangel. Has had tons of success in his career. Probably only second to Coach Curtis in the number of state championships that he's won. So for us, we're getting a dominant football team that has thrived on their ability to make big plays. They've created 50-something turnovers in their 13 games. So we know the type of to matchup that we have. But I know I've told us to our quarterback club all year long. I don't know how far this team's going to go. But I know what you're going to get every Friday night from them, and that's the absolute best. So we don't expect anything less Saturday at noon.
What kind of pride do you take seeing Three River Parish teams in the dome this week?
Well, it's extremely exciting. It's especially exciting when you know that when the scoreboard's been on and the lights have been off, we've lost two times on the field this year. We lost to Destrehan and a Jamboree, 20-10, where we had the ball and was driving it down to end that game. And we lost 21-20 to St. Charles on the last play of the game where we ended up on a 4-yard line. So it means that those games, you talk about them during the year, you play those games because you think they'll get you prepared for the playoffs and obviously playing that quality of competition. But not only that, when you play football in the River Parishes, you know it's going to be a big game atmosphere. So you know anything that you'll see later on in the season, you'll be prepared for it once you play those games.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.
Well done, Dwayne.
Thank you.
Thank you, buddy.